Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to invoice a customer in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. One of the most challenging aspects of running a business is the ability to keep track of your income and expenses. A key advantage to Xero is the ability to create professional invoices. In addition to getting paid faster, this makes it much easier to see who's paid you and who has not. Here are just a few of the benefits to creating invoices in Xero. Customers can pay via credit card or ACH directly on the invoice. It provides your customer with the details of the products and or services they have purchased on a professionally formatted document. In the How to Set Up Invoices lesson, we showed you how to customize your invoices by selecting a branding theme or template and adding your company logo. You can click here to access this lesson. You are able to assign the account that you want to track the income when you create the invoice so that Xero can perform the accounting for you in the background. And finally, your accounts receivable balance is always up to date. In this lesson, we'll walk you through the steps to invoice a customer. This will include how to modify invoices, how to invoice a group of customers for the same products and services, and how to create a repeating invoice for those customers who you bill on a periodic basis, for example, monthly or quarterly. To create an invoice for a customer in Xero, you want to go ahead and navigate to the Accounts menu and select Sales. From this screen, you want to go ahead and click on the New button and select Invoice. Now let's talk about the information that we need to provide in each of these fields to create a new invoice. In the To field from the dropdown, you want to go ahead and select the customer that you would like to bill. If the customer does not exist, Xero will add the new customer to your contacts list if you just click on Add New. The Date field will automatically populate with today's date. If you'd like to change the date, you can simply click the dropdown and select the appropriate date. The due date will automatically populate based on the default due date setup in the How to Set Up Invoices lesson. However, if you need to change the due date, you can also do that here by clicking on the dropdown and selecting the appropriate due date. The invoice number field will automatically populate with the next available invoice number. This is in order to avoid duplicate numbers. To learn more about how to customize the starting invoice number, view our lesson on how to set up invoices. You can click here to access this lesson. If applicable, you can enter additional information about the sale, such as a purchase order number, as we have done here. Branding. This field will automatically populate with the branding theme or template that was selected during invoice setup. If you would like to use a different branding theme, you can simply click the dropdown and select the appropriate one. This Attach File icon allows you to attach documents such as signed contracts, pictures, or other documents that you would like to attach to this invoice so that you can keep them for internal purposes only. You can also allow your customer to view these documents when they view their invoices if you'd like. Item. If you are billing for an item that you frequently use, then you can select it from the drop-down menu here. And then as you will see or just saw, all of the information will populate for you. So description will automatically populate based on the item that you selected here. You can leave the description here, or you can actually make changes as you need to. For the quantity here, you want to make sure that you bill the appropriate quantity if you're selling products. For services, you want to enter a quantity of 1. The unit price field will automatically populate based on the price that was set up for the item. If the pricing that you'd like to bill is different from the default, you can adjust it in this field directly. Discount percentage. If there is a discount that you would like to apply, you can go ahead and enter that here. If you set the customer up to automatically receive a discount, this field will automatically populate for you. Account. This field will automatically populate based on the item that was selected. However, from the dropdown, you can also select an account that you would like for this to be coded to. In the tax rate field, this will automatically populate based on the item that was selected. However, you can select a different tax rate from the dropdown if you need to. Be sure to check out the sales tax rates lesson to learn more. You can click here to access this lesson. The region field is actually called a tracking category field. In the invoice setup lesson, we discussed how to track other areas of your business like location, department, or region, as in this example. You can click here to access this lesson. Xero will automatically calculate the amount for you by multiplying the quantity by the unit price field. Please note that if you need to bill a customer in their native currency, you can do so. Be sure to turn on the multi-currency feature to have this option show up when creating customer invoices. You can click here to access this lesson. If you need to add a line item, you can do so by clicking this button here. Once you have completed all of the fields, you can click the Save button here or the Approve button. The save options here are very similar to what we discussed in the previous lesson. You can save as a draft. This option will save your invoice and allow you to close out of the screen. The Save and Continue Editing. This option will allow you to save your invoice before you are done with it. You can save periodically so that you don't lose information. You have an option here to save and submit for approval. So that will save the invoice and then submit it to the person that approves invoices in your organization. And then finally, save and add another. This option will save your invoices as a draft, and then it will open up a new blank invoice for you to complete. So this can be convenient if you've got several invoices that you need to go ahead and enter into Xero, either for multiple customers or the same customer. For the approval, if you have the ability to approve, then you will see this green approve button here. And let's talk about the options available there. So the first option, approve, this option will save your invoice and you can send it via email to your customer. The next option, approve and add another, this option will save your invoice as approved and it will open a new invoice screen for you to create another invoice. This feature allows you to create invoices much faster because you don't have to close out of the screen to create the next one. Approve and view next. This option allows you to approve the invoice and then view any invoices that may be awaiting your approval. And then how to invite users to Xero, we discuss how to give users permission to approve invoices. You can click here to access this lesson. And finally, approve and print. This option will approve the invoice and allow you to print it as well. So we'll go ahead and approve this invoice. And then as you can see, we've got our notification that the invoice was approved, at which time we can actually go in and add another invoice if we'd like. After approving the invoice, we can go ahead and email it to our customer by clicking this email option here. So let's do that. And then you will see an email template similar to this one pop up on the screen. So in the to field, you want to include the email address of the person or persons who should receive the invoices. As indicated here, you can include more than one person. You just want to make sure to put the semicolon in between the email address for each person's email address that you enter here. The subject is automatically populated by Xero, but as you can see, you can type directly in this field and make any necessary changes that you'd like to. The body of the invoice is the same in that you can keep the standard messaging that you see here, or you can make changes to it. Notice here that a link to the actual invoice will be included with the email so that the customer can access the invoice online. And they also can pay directly online by clicking that link. Right below the body of the email message, we've got four options here. The first one says include files as attachments. If you have attached files to this invoice and you would like to share those files with your customer, put a check mark in this box. Otherwise, you can leave it blank if the file attachments are for your internal use only. The second option here, include PDF attachment. If you would like to attach a PDF version of the invoice in addition to the online version of the invoice, so that the customer can download and save the invoice to their computer, you can click this option to include a PDF attachment of the invoice. The third option here, mark as sent. By selecting this option, Xero will mark this invoice as sent to your customer. This will help you to keep track of the status of the invoice. So I highly recommend that you have this marked automatically for you. And then the last option here, similar to what we talked about in the last lesson, you can be copied on the email that is sent to your customer with the invoice by selecting the send me a copy option here. And then once you've made all of your changes, you want to go ahead and click the green send button and your invoice will be sent to the customer. Please note that one of the features that makes Xero stand out from its competitors is Xero to Xero. If you have a customer or supplier who also uses Xero, you can easily send and receive invoices without emailing them. For step-by-step instructions on how to send an invoice to another Xero user, click the link below this video. Xero makes it easy to make changes to an invoice if you need to. So let's go ahead and return to our invoices by going to the accounts and sales. And then you should see invoices here. And we've got four groups here that invoices fall into: draft, awaiting approval, awaiting payment, and overdue. All right, so let's talk about the draft invoices. Draft invoices are invoices that you've created, but you have not approved them or submitted them for approval. So please note that invoices in this group have no impact on your financial statements. Awaiting approval. These invoices have been submitted for approval, but they have not yet been approved. Please note that the invoices in this group do affect your financial statements. Awaiting payment. The invoices in this group have been sent to customers, but have not been paid yet. Please also note that these invoices do affect your financial statements. And then finally, overdue. These are invoices that have been sent to customers and they have not been paid as of their due dates, which makes them overdue or past due. In the How to Create an Accounts Receivable Aging Report lesson, I will share some tips with you on how to stay on top of your accounts receivable balances. You can click here to access this lesson. Notice down here, we've got a section that says money coming in. So what's nice about this is you can click on a particular bar, actually hover over a particular bar as well, to see the customer and the dollar amount for each section of the bar graph. You can also click on the bar graph and it will actually display the invoices that make up the amount shown here. Customers owing the most. This can also be very helpful. This will allow you to easily pinpoint those customers who, for example, have past due or overdue balances as indicated in red here. And so what you'll notice is that the overdue balance amount here actually is made up of balances that are outstanding for these three customers here. So it makes it pretty easy to quickly hone in on what customers you need to pick up the phone and make a phone call to, or perhaps send a friendly reminder to as well. To modify an invoice, you want to go ahead and click on the group that the invoice falls into. And then from this screen, you can actually just click on the invoice that you want to make changes to. Anywhere in the row will actually allow the invoice to display. And once you do that, we've got our invoice options here, things that we can do outlined here listed under invoice options. So let's talk about each of these. Online payments. You want to select this option to add a payment service to your invoices which will allow customers to make online payments. To learn how to set up a payment service, check out our How to Customize Invoices lesson. You can click here to access this lesson. Repeat. Xero allows you to create recurring transactions like invoices and bills. For example, if you have a customer that you bill $100 on a monthly basis, you can set up the invoice as a repeating invoice in Xero so that it will automatically be created for you and emailed to the customer. Click the link below this video for more information on recurring transactions. Third option here is void. If for some reason you want to get rid of an invoice that was previously created, you can generally delete it as long as it is in a draft or awaiting approval status. However, if the invoice is awaiting payment or has already been paid, then you will need to void it. Please also note that you will need to remove payments and credits applied to an invoice before you can actually void the invoice. Click the link below this video for more information. Copy to. You can create a brand new invoice, quote, purchase order, or bill from an existing invoice. Just click the Copy to button, select the form you would like to create, and enter the customer or supplier contact's name. Edit. Select the Edit option to make changes to the quantity, description, or any information on the invoice, and then be sure to save your changes. Add a credit note. If the customer has an outstanding credit note that you would like to apply to an invoice, click this button and select the appropriate credit note to apply. Share invoice. You can share a link to an invoice that is either awaiting payment or in a paid status. Click this button to see a URL that you can copy and paste into an email to send to your customer. And finally, turn invoice reminders off. Xero makes it super easy to manage your accounts receivable with the automatic invoice reminder feature. In the How to Set Up Invoices lesson, we show you how to turn on payment reminders to your customers so that they receive a notification a few days before an invoice is due or after the due date. You can click here to access this lesson. This feature shown above allows you to turn off automatic reminders for an invoice if for some reason that you need to do so. Xero allows you to group your customer contacts that have something in common. For example, you might group customers you send the same invoice to. So for example, Acme Web Pros Plus would like to create an invoice for a group of customers who are billed $300 each quarter for digital marketing services. So let's go ahead and walk through the steps on how we would do this in Xero. From the Xero dashboard, go ahead and select Accounts and Sales. Click on our new button and we'll go down and select repeating invoice. From the new repeating invoice button, go ahead and select quarterly customer billing. If you have not set up the group yet, then you want to go ahead and do that by clicking on add contact group, and then you can come back and set up the repeating invoice. Okay, once you do that, the invoice template should display and you want to complete all the required fields of what you want to bill your customers for, like we have done in this screen. Once you have done that, go ahead and click the Create Draft Invoices button here. So we'll go ahead and do that. And as you can see here, it says that 3 draft invoices were created for our quarterly customer billing. And so as you can see, we've got our 3 invoices here that were created. At this point, we could actually mark these invoices and go ahead and approve them if you have the ability to approve invoices. Otherwise, you would submit them for approval. That wraps up the lesson on how to invoice a customer in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.